Ano ang pagkakaiba ng LDL sa taong kumakain ng high carb at sa taong kumakain ng low carb or other foods na walang inflammation? So nakikita natin na common sa mga taong nagki-keto o naglo-low carb ay tumataas yung LDL nila. What is good though ay meron na ngayong studies showing na yung LDL na sa taong naglo-low carb o naglo-lower down ng kanyang inflammation are actually not the same as the LDL sa isang taong kumakain ng high carb or sweets and other inflammatory foods. Yung pagkakaiba nito is within the density. Yung delikadong LDL is also known as small dense LDL. Maliliit but marami in quantity. So yung LDL po na kinakatakutan are also known as the small dense LDL. Ito yung marami in numbers but are also very small when it comes to density. Ito yung mataas yung risk for heart attacks, atherosclerosis, stroke, at marami pang iba. But the LDL that is common among those people practicing low carb and keto and other diet that lowers inflammation are not the dangerous types of LDL because this is of large density. Paano natin ito ma-appreciate? So, if you can think of LDL of fats, no, you can think of a regular egg, so itlog. Kapag ito ay small, dense na itlog, for example, yung itlog ng pugo, you will need about 50 or maybe 100 eggs of pugo para lang po makabuo ng isang kilo. Pero, if you will take the egg of an ostrich, you will only need one ostrich egg. Or if you take into consideration yung duck or chicken eggs, you will only need maybe about 20 eggs para mabuo yung 1 kilo na yon. So with this, you can appreciate na yung LDL ng isang taong naka-low carb na parehong nasa 150 as compared sa LDL ng isang naka-high carb na 150 din. Yung 150 ng naka-high carb or normal diet would be too much when it comes to the number of LDL molecules. These are small density LDL as compared to a larger density LDL that are usually occurring or nakikita natin when it comes to low carb or those practicing keto and other healthy diets. But of course, it doesn't mean na kapag meron kayong mataas na LDL ay okay na okay lang ito. If you want to normalize it, may paraan naman dyan. And that is for another video. Just know by now na kapag yung LDL po ninyo ay medyo mataas than normal, but as long as wala itong kasabay na inflammatory markers such as too much insulin, too much blood glucose in the body that is seen in high FBS or high HbA1c, and also mababa po yung triglycerides compared to your HDL levels, having some degree of elevated LDL should not cause you to worry too much because there are different kinds of LDL. Hindi po lahat ng LDL are created equal. So, always be knowledgeable before jumping into conclusions. Learn, do your research, and baka you would consider in staying low carb so that you will also stay safe.